here at the Beatles story, they've collected 60s memorabilia to, as faithfully as you possibly can, recreate the Merseybeat era when the Beatles were in their pomp. And yet, there's one man's iconic work and imagery which is utterly integral to that story, and I bet you've never even heard of him. Love, love me do. You know I love you.
I'll always be true. So please. The posters of their time, which I remember in the early 1960s, I remember them on the billboards. They just bring back so many memories.
It was around the era of 3D, and they stood out like 3D to us.
The height of Merseybeat, what became Beatlemania, the defining poster image, they're Tonys, really. Someone like you.
Meet Tony Booth, the quiet man of the Beatles story. Back in the 60s, as the young Fab Four were learning their trade playing the ballrooms of Merseyside, there was, of course, no social media. So the only way people could find out where they could be seen was through word of mouth, or on a poster. And that's where Tony came in. Like the Beatles, he was discovered by Brian Epstein.
In the early 60s, I worked in Liverpool City Centre in Whitechapel. And Brian Epstein had an office over his shop, a shop called Nems. When I first met Brian, I was just in a few posters and show cards for his shops. Later on, he became interested in rock and roll, and when he went to the Cavern and met the Beatles for the first time, he started having posters done for them. I did most of the posters for the Liverpool area in the early 60s. I must have done hundreds of them. I used to be given carte blanche to change what I wanted to do. I could say the Fabulous Beatles, which I often did, or if Joe Flannery was producing that show, I'd put his name on, of course.
Joe Flannery was Brian Epstein's right-hand man, putting on shows which featured a host of Liverpool bands.
Tony Booth became our poster man. He was well known and there was posters about and we liked them very much. We liked his style and they were to the point, and you know, some posters you look at them and they don't mean a thing, but you can read Tony Booth's posters, but we liked them from the beginning. Sometimes he'd say, keep it white, have the bold. It was a good discussion to have Tony in to work out the posters.
The posters followed the music to venues right across Merseyside. Ray O'Brien wrote a book detailing all the places the Beatles played locally.
Well, this is the Grosvenor Ballroom in Wallasey, where the Beatles played on 14 occasions between 1960 and 1961. And this is the actual stage that the Beatles performed on, with the piano still here, which in all probability Paul McCartney played. And here we are in the bar area with three of Tony's posters, Silver Beatles with two E's, the Beatles as we all know them, and the Silver Beatles, B-E-A-T-L-E-S.
I think the posters are brilliant, fantastic work of ours. And the posters would have been in the local record shops, would have been on billboards in the local area, and possibly, yes, there would be a poster outside the building itself.
It wasn't just the Beatles, it was a lot of the other local bands like the Remo Four, like the Undertakers, like Jerry and the Pacemakers, like the Searchers. They're one-offs. Nobody else can reproduce the work that Tony's done. Fans from all over the world just so pleased to get a copy of one of his posters. And it's a little bit of history, of course.
This poster of Tony's from 1962, with the Beatles supporting Little Richard, is a bit of history too. It was found just 2 years ago by workmen renovating Bidston Station on Wirral.
They were chipping away and they came across this poster, and as more became revealed, they saw the Beatles and thought, oh, this could be quite important. A very famous gig in New Brighton.
It's also classic Tony Booth.
He is there to sell the promoter's tickets, but he does it in an iconic way, dynamic print, and some of it is quite classic print, the Beatles, Little Richard. It's selling, yeah, it's commercial art.
This is machine glazed paper, but I'm still using the 50-year-old original.
Is it? Yeah. You kept hold of some of the old rolls.
I've got my last roll over there, yeah.
Today, aged 82, Tony is as busy as ever, still making hand-drawn replicas of his own 60s classics in his front room in Moreton-on-Wirral. Nowadays, they're made for fans and collectors all over the world.
A pencil layout out.
Yeah.
And then just start lettering, one-stroke lettering with a brush like that.
Music posters on his only legacy. Apart from being a skilled portrait artist, Tony, it seems, also created his own font, and it's one which we've all seen in shops right across the world.
They were going to call it Booth Bold, after my name, and then they asked me, they decided to change it to Sale, they call it Sale.
Okay. I think they should have called it Booth Bold myself.
Well, yeah.
I think they missed a trick there.
Do you? Welcome, my people,
let's move it and groove it. At Fort Perch Rock in New Brighton, they hold a monthly Merseybeat reunion gig, and Tony and wife June are regular visitors. It's a chance for him to renew old acquaintances and to sit back and enjoy the musicians he used to publicise back in the 60s. Today's event is commemorating Merseybeat stalwart Harry Prithitch of the Remo 4, who recently passed away. Tony has designed a memorial plaque. Last year, he did the same when Cilla Black died. And when the producers of the Cilla TV drama wanted to capture the poster look of the cavern in the 60s, there was only one man to turn to.
I had to replicate all the posters that were stuck on the wall outside the Cavern Club. Exactly the same proportion, size, and the same lettering and everything.
They're opened a new jazz club. It was called The Cavern.
When The Cavern first opened its doors in 1957, Tony, who else, designed the launch poster. And at the height of Merseybeat, he produced all the posters there, designing the famous vertical cavern sign, as well as the information on the walls downstairs. We took him back to Matthew Street, where the current owners were blissfully unaware that Tony was still alive and printing.
It's our heritage. As a city, it's our musical heritage. This is the one, the first night of the Cavern, because yeah. It's everything, the Merseysippy Jazz Band. That's incredible. 59 years ago.
That should be on your exhibition, shouldn't it?
Absolutely, yeah. I love the layout and that. Yeah. It's there's so much going on, but it all reads as one, doesn't it?
Thank you.
Oh God, that's the one. That's the one. That should be outside the Cavern now. And you see so many pictures of the Cavern in the early 60s, and original advertising material. And I always say, you could put that in the Echo now, and it would be as relevant today as it was then.
So relevant, John wants to give Tony a gig.
We're coming up to our 60th anniversary, so we'd love Tony to possibly do, you know, our official 60th anniversary poster. You know, my new best friend, Tony.
And so, remarkably, 60 years after he produced his first Cavern poster, Tony Booth will be doing it all again. Make some noise for the quiet man, the poster boy for the Beatle generation.